gosh.
A pleasant day, everyone. The first question from the given module, why was the focus of education different for different groups of people in different places and at different periods in world history? In this case, what is the relationship of schools in society? I think the reason behind why the focus of education different for different groups of peoples and different at different periods in world history, it is because all of them have unique mission and vision. All of them have unique ideas and beliefs for so to educate, taught, disseminate, and build where they think it is good for all. Like the time of Spanish period, we cannot totally say that they brings negative influence. It is true that they use their religion as advantage on us, but we become religious. The relationship of schools in society. The school used to educate and taught individuals their roles and duties in the societies. The school is place taught us about the concept of society by fostering real-life situation. Schools serve us as a training ground, and the society is our battleground. Question number 2, given the characteristic of different periods in Philippine history, what were the goal of education schools during the pre-colonial period? The focus of education and schools in the time of pre-colonial period was more on vocational training but lesser academics for them to be good fathers and mothers. Spanish period, the goal or focus of education schools in the time of Spanish period was to disseminate their religion, to educate and taught Filipino about Catholicism. American regime, the focus of education schools in the time of American regime was to educate and taught Filipino people on how to become good citizen on democratic country. Japanese regime, the major focus of education schools in the Japanese regime was to educate and taught Filipino labs of labor. Post-colonial period, the major focus of education school in the post-colonial period was to taught and educate Filipinos to foster love of country, teach the duties of citizenship, develop a moral character and self-discipline, scientific, technological, and vocational efficiency. Next question, look for the statement, deep edge mission and vision. Has the Philippine education system from pre-colonial to present given equal access to quality, culture-based, and complete basic education, or it was a privilege of few? Explain your answer. Based from deep edge mission and vision, in the Philippines education system, from pre-colonial to present, given equal access to quality, culture-based, and complete basic education, and it is not privilege of few. All are welcome. There is no discrimination in terms of education, and this is one of the major rights of a citizen of the state. Next question, education is a function of society. Considering the positive and negative element of 21st century society, state the 21st century ideal graduate. The ideal 21st century graduate are fully equipped with knowledge, skills, ability, good moral character, and other more aspects of life. It can be mentally, physically, socially, and spiritually. Also, the ideal 21st century graduate known and aware how to execute or handle their big responsibility and how to play their role in the society. Last but not the least, the 21st century ideal graduate are globally competent. Describe the education delivery mode. The education delivery mode at present, as we can see in experience, it is learner-centered based, where the teacher briefly discusses the lesson and after that, the students and learners have task outputs needed to accomplish, while the teacher guides them and facilitator of learning. Unlike before, spoon-feeding, where the teacher is the one who give and feed knowledge on his and her students. The student just sit in their chair and listen until the class ends. Will survival skills taught in the primitive societies suffice for the citizens of 21st century world? For me, the survival skills taught in the primitive societies is not suffice for the citizens of 21st century world because the situation before to present is very different. Before, we need to hunt animals and look for fruits in order to gather foods. But today, we are able to plant and carry animals. Also, we have permanent home secured from wild animals, unlike before, nomadic or no permanent home. In 21st century worlds, the skills should be taught for the citizens are the learning skills, literacy skills, and life skills.